Hello everyone, welcome to our channel DexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai and in this particular video I'll be talking about how to import data on PostgreSQL. Sometimes what happens is that when you're importing your data through the conventional method, it doesn't work. So I wanted to address this particular problem. Why? Because I've seen that there are not many videos or blogs on this particular topic. Also, I realized that instead of including more of like Python related videos, I also wanted to do more of error related videos which might you face during the process of working with Python language or any other languages, per se SQL or something like that. So that's that. If you haven't watched my previous video regarding the time series analysis or time series forecasting, you can go ahead and click on the I icon on the right hand side corner of your screen so that you are directed to those videos. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. This is my PG admin for PostgreSQL. Now the first thing what we want to do is we want to create our servers, and for that what we are going to do is we are going to right click on the server icon and create a click on server, then write down the name, whatever name you want to write. So here I am writing Niharika Rai. And then I also want to mention my host name. Now remember that the host name has to be same as your PostgreSQL shell. So what we are going to do is we are going to write ps shell, and here my server host name is localhost. So we are going to write here localhost. Sometimes what people tend to do is they tend to forget that they need to add the password here as well, and that creates a bit of problem where, because you don't know what the error is because it's not showing you. Like if I go ahead and click there, you see that unable to connect server, no password supplied. So you see, we need to supply the password, whatever the password we've been initially used to install PostgreSQL. So here I'm going to write my password so that this problem does not occur. Obviously I'm not going to show what my password is. So yeah, here I have my server. One of my server has to be removed, so I have two of my servers. So let's remove the first one here. Yeah, so here I now the next step is to create a database. Now to create a database, again we are going to use this server to create our database. Select database, write the name of the database. So here I am writing UCB admission. Yeah, so here I have my database, that is UCB admission, and now I'm going to click that. You see Niharika UCB database connected, and we are directly moved towards schema. Schema is nothing but the structure of your data which you want to import. So we are going to click on schema. We get a bunch of options. From that we are going to click on your tables option and right click on that and create table. Now what you want to do is you want to create the table or the sheet name which you want to create. Write down the name of the table, and then we are going to use create table query to write down the exact column names which are in my data set which we want to import. So here I am going to import UCB. Hopefully this particular data set is not there. Yes, it's not. Table is not there. So now UCB, after clicking on the UCB option, we are going to use the query editing tool. and we are going to start writing our query to create our table. So we all know that to create a table, we need to use create table query, use our table name UCB, and I'm going to import this particular data set. So for that, I am going to directly import all the columns. Directly take all the columns, copy paste them in this sheet here. Also, I'm going to mention the data type. They are tab separated. So, yeah, text, comma, gender also has to be in text, or you can write varchar if you want to. Department is also going to be in text format, and frequency has to be in integer format. It can be in float, so it's your wish if you want to write it in that format. Semicolon, and let's run this particular query. Query returned successfully in 222 milliseconds. Now let's check if our table has, we have been able to manage to create our table or not. So for that, again a select star from, we have created UCB table, so let's check that out. And here we go, we have all the columns: index, admit, gender, department, and frequency. Now all we need to do is we need to import our data. So for that, or this particular table, now for that I'm going to use a query. Again, copy UCB, that is my table which we want to extract. Now remember that this particular table name has to be the same which we have just created. Okay, so again, just going to copy this part again. The name of the columns separated by comma, not tab. And then we want to mention the path of the file. Now what happens is sometimes the C type does not give us the permission to import our data. Okay, so the path does not work and the error comes in as permission denied. So if I copy the path, I'll show you the difference between that as well. So here we go, let me just open the sheet for you. Now here you see that the path is in C drive, the C users text lab, and so on and so forth. So I'm going to copy this path to show you what error we get when we are using C drive path. Delimiter, since we are using comma separated files, delimiter CSV. Remember that SQL is not case sensitive, so we can write it in uppercase or lowercase. That is why we have this particular delimiter is okay to write. We have our headers to the column, that is why. Now let's run this particular code. You see, we get a permission denied error. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to change the path from C drive to any other drive so that we are able to extract that particular file. So here I am going to remove this path, change my path and I'm going to use path of this particular folder. So here I have same file but saved in another folder, another drive per se, and here we go. Just want to make sure that it is copied. Now let's run this entire code. Query returned successfully in 294 milliseconds. Now let's check if my data is imported, has imported or not. We were able to import it or not. So for that again, now you can use directly write the query, or you can copy paste from the previous query. So select star from, copy the query, and then you are good to go. But I am going to write it down directly. Just kidding, I am not going to write it down. Here you go. So here we have our data now in index, admit card, gender, department and frequency. Hence we were able to solve our problem. Now one more thing I want to add is here that in case you do not see your UCB, initially if you do not see your UCB admission table just you created or something like that, what you can do is you can just go ahead and refresh the entire page. So per se you do not see your UCB ka file tab, then go ahead, refresh this and you'll be able to do that. Okay, so that's it for this video. Hope you learned something new in this particular video. Please go ahead and like this video, share and also subscribe if you haven't already. Click on the notification button so that whenever I post my videos, you get my videos and you're able to see them as quickly as possible. If you want to contact us, you can mail us at hello@techslabanalytics.com. You can also visit our website, or you can WhatsApp us, or you can call us directly via the given numbers on the screen. We are currently placed in Gurgaon. Hope you are doing well, and bye-bye. Take care.